Hello everyone, this is Saurabh Kumar and I welcome you all to my video series of CISSP, where today we are going to talk about protection mechanism. Protection mechanism is one of the most common characteristic for security controls, and all the security professional, they look for some of the option which they can use to protect the document, to protect the data, to protect the resources. So basically many control offer different kind of protection to fulfill our CIA requirement, confidentiality, integrity and availability requirement. So here in this particular video I will be talking about some of the terms which comes under the chapter number 1 of CISSP program. So very common type of or common example of mechanism may include, such as here you can see, multiple layers, or we can call it also layers of access, or also we call it layering. So first we will be talking about layering. Then the second thing, we will be talking about employing abstraction, or you can just call it abstraction. So that will be the second point which we will be talking about in this video. Third, we'll be talking about hiding data. This is another term, and what does it mean, how to do it and all. And then encryption. So these are the four points which we are going to actually discuss in this particular video. So let's have a look on it. Let's begin with layering first of all. What is layering is? To protect our data, first thing we may think about to putting the security on it. But security can be implemented into two format. It can be implemented into the parallel layering. It can be implemented into the serial layering. And obviously, when we compare between parallel security level layering and serial security level layering, security will be better choice. Why? Let me first give you one example, and then I will be going through the technical terms of layering. So maybe if I talk about like this, maybe I have a shopping mall here. You may have been visiting so many number of shopping mall. So shopping malls are having so many maybe different gates where from you can enter. And each gate are having some different kind of security control check. So maybe there is a security guy here who will be checking your bag and everything, and then they allow you to go inside. Then maybe some of the gate are having automatic condition where you put everything, machine will detect it all, and then you pass through it, and then you access the supermarket. So these kind condition will be called as a parallel layering, where we have multiples different security we have implemented, but they all are parallel. So anybody who is outside, who want to go inside the shopping mall, they may just found maybe a vulnerability in any one of these also, and they can easily enter to the shopping mall. The meaning that we have different type of security, but each of the different type of security are working into the parallel format. So even one is having vulnerability, that will be enough for a hacker or attacker to go inside the shopping mall and get whatever they want. But when we talk about a serial, I can take example of maybe like airport. So maybe if you have a flight, if you want to take a flight, so maybe this is the area where the flight is. So to reach up to that area, you may have to follow so many different security layer. Maybe first of all you have to do check-in here, where you will be checked with the baggage and your handbag and everything. Then you even before that you may have to show maybe your ticket, so that the security guard will allow you to enter. So you have first one security, then they will be doing check-in, then there will be another kind of security check-in, then there will be a lobby where will be a waiting area where you are going to wait for your flight. So in that lobby area also there will be a gate, and at that gate also there will be a security checking here as well. So now you can see we have 1, 2, and 3 security points, and all of these 3 security points are walking into the serial order. So now if somebody maybe a person or somebody else maybe want to enter up to the flight, it is not going to be possible. Even when you are going inside the flight, again there will be some attendee, and they will be checking again your ticket plus seat, your seat number. So here you have to follow this all 4 security area, then only you will be allowed to reach into the flight. Similarly in our day-to-day life also, similarly in our security world, similarly in our cyber world, we can also implement security into the serial format. Maybe like a company is having a server here, and that server I want it to be very highly secured, so I can put put first of all a firewall. If somebody cross the firewall, then they may go through the IDS and IPS device. And then after crossing IDS and IPS, then they may go to the router where maybe I have configured access control list. Then they will be going to the switch where maybe I have added MAC filtering. Then they will be going to the computer where I have so many already kind of different kind of security and authentication, authorization, and all those kind of things I have implemented. So here the format is into the serial way, and this is what exactly the layering means. Whenever a layering term comes in our security world, it means that the security which you are using in how many different layers and how you have arranged them. Are you using them in a parallel format or are you using them into a serial format? So here you can see this is creating one layer, then this is another layer, this is another layer. So these are what actually layering is. It is all layer you have to cross if you want to reach up to the resources. So this is what actually layering is. So now we can go back and we can have a look on technical terms. So layering, also known as defense in depth, and is simply the use of multiple control into the series order. Second point, using a multi-layer solution allow numerous different control of guard against whether threat comes to pass. So any threats or maybe any hacker, if they want to reach up to your victim device, they may have to find out so many different vulnerability in all each of the layer which comes between him and your device, which is not very possible. Then using layer in a series rather than a parallel is more important, as I explained you before. Performing security restriction in a series means to perform one after other in a linear fashion, as I explained. In a series configuration, failure of a single security control does not render the entire solution. So maybe if somebody even pass one gate, there is another gate where the security is different kind of things, where you are using different kind of security, different level of security, and a hacker will not have maybe any kind of bypass method to that one. So at the end, the result is your data is still protected, your network is still protected, your device is still protected. So that was all about the layering. Now we are going to talk about the second thing, which is called as a abstraction. Abstraction, very simply, abstraction means, as I explained earlier also in my previous video, that whenever we want to implement any kind of security, very first thing we have to be doing is categorizing our resources on the basis of their security label, on the basis of their importance. So whenever we have any list of resource, first thing we do is we categorize them, we put them into the order that this is my top secret, this is mediator label, or this is very less secure kind of information we have. So on the basis of their categorization, on the basis of their label, we can implement the security things on it. So that is what actually abstraction means. So here we can have a look on it. Abstraction is used for efficiency because it helps you to find out what kind of or maybe how fast or vast kind of security you supposed to implement on which kind of data. Second is similar elements are put into a group. Maybe you have some resources which are less secure, you put them into the same group. Some resources you have which is very highly secure, you need to make them highly secure, or they are very, very confidential, you have to put them into different group. So we categorize them, we put them in a different group or classes or the roles, so that it will be easy for us to assign any kind of security control, any kind of restriction, either allow, either deny permissions as collective. The third thing is abstraction is used to define what type of data an object can contain, which kind of information you are going to put into which kind of folder, and then what type of function can be performed on it, either allow, deny, another thing on the that object, plus what capability that object has. So these are the things we do it. First of all, we do it on the paper, we decide everything on the paper, and then we implement it in our real scenario. Then the third we have is data hiding. Data hiding is obviously everybody know by its name itself, that whatever information you have, if you want to hide it so that even the other user cannot see it, that is what data hiding means. So data hiding is something like preventing somebody to access your resources by hiding your information. Maybe you have made it hidden, or maybe you have not given even read permission to any user on any particular data. So those all comes under the category of data hiding. So data data hiding is like a act of intentionally positioning data. If you are doing it intentionally, you are positioning any data, you are keeping your any data into a location or any place which is not maybe viewable or accessible to any unauthorized subject or any person. That is what data hiding means. Sometime whenever I explain about data hiding, people compare it with one more term, which is known as security through obscurity. So don't get confused between data hiding and security through obscurity. They are different thing. As I told you before, data hiding is something which you do intentionally to hide your data so nobody can see it. But when we compare it with the security through obscurity, it is, you are not going to hide anything. You are not going to put something in a different location. What exactly security through obscurity means that you are just assuming, you are just hoping that maybe the user will not be able to see it. That is what security through obscurity is. That is not data hiding. So there is a difference in data hiding. Data hiding means you are doing something change on the data. You are making sure that it is not accessible, it is hidden. But security through obscurity is where you are just assuming, maybe like a programmer, maybe a software engineer, they program, they make maybe any kind of software, and then they are just assuming that nobody is going to check what is the code has been used to made this particular program. So they are just assuming, they are not hiding the information. So in that scenario, it will be known as a security through obscurity. So there is a difference between them, and I hope it is clear with you now. So security through obscurity does not actually implement any form of protection. You are just doing what? It is instead of an attempt to hope something important is not discovered by keeping knowledge of it is secret. Then the next point we have is encryption, and which is very much clear as per its name itself. Encryption means you are just changing any plain text data, whatever you have, whatever plain text you have, you are just using some code and you are going to change it to the secret value. So that is what encryption means. Encryption means keeping your data, converting, you can call it even converting, but converting will be not the right word. So just making a plain text, changing it into the format of any secret information with using some kind of key, and that is how it will be encrypted. So no any person can directly read it, or no any maybe somebody using data sniffing, somebody using packet sniffing, somebody using network sniffing, they will not be able to easily read it. So encryption can be used in both scenario, either when it is stored at one place, your data is stored at any particular location, or either when it is in transition, when it is being transferred from one place to another place also, we can have encryption so nobody can gather the information from my data. So encryption is an art and science of hiding the meaning of intent of a communication from unintended recipient. Second point is encryption is very important element in security control, especially when we talk about when data is being transfer from one place to another, so that anybody is doing maybe using Wireshark, or maybe somebody is having his network interface in promiscuous mode and they are trying to read your data, they will not be able to read it because it is in encrypted format. And again, encryption will be coming again in our seventh number of chapter in CISSP program, where we will be having a lot of detail and brief on encryption, as well as symmetric, asymmetric, and all those kind of things. So there I will be explaining again what exactly encryption is and how many different types of encryption are. So in this video, we have just talked about these four terms. Before I end up, let me summarize it with one slide here. So to do the protection mechanism, we can use two type of mechanism. We can use technical mechanism, or we can use policy mechanism. In technical mechanism, we can use layering, which I discuss in this video. We can use abstraction, which I explain in this video. We can also use data hiding, which I have been explaining. Then we can also use process isolation, like many of the programmer, they do that. They separate the memory space for different thing. Even when we talk about maybe like you are running virtual machine in your physical, that's what actually it separates the memory spaces, and also it separates some hardware part of the devices. So that's how actually it is also going to help to secure the data so that whatever resource are there in your virtual machine cannot be read through the physical machine user, and whatever resource you have in your physical machine cannot be read through the virtual machine user. So that those are some of the technical mechanism of protection mechanism. When we talk about the policy mechanism, we may have some security policy, we may create some kind of rule, regulation and procedure which we will be following. Then second thing can be, we have to give least privilege to each of the user so that they don't have any kind of authority to do any kind of change until unless they are not allowed to do so. Then we can also have separation of privilege. Rather than giving all privilege to one user, you should always divide this privilege into different user, so that until unless they all are not combined, nothing is going to be happen. Nobody can do a big change in your network environment, or maybe they cannot hack your network or your resources. Then the last and very important is, you must fulfill your you must go through the accountability. You must check all the log files, you must verify everything, that which user has access which resource, what kind of modification was done, which date it was done, and all those kind of things. So once you implement this all, that's how your data will be very much protected. And that's why this topic name was protection mechanism. What are the methods, what are the mechanism we may use to protect our resources, to protect our data, to protect our information, to protect our network, to protect our system, to protect our entire organization. So this was all about in this video, where we have talked about protection mechanism. And I hope this video was informative for you all. And I would like to thank you for watching.